process. The Council on Rural Development is essentially a neutral, independent convener of community and public process in Vermont. We work on behalf of communities all around the state to where we're invited, we only work where we're invited by town leadership, to come to the community, to bring folks together, and to ask the question, what are the things that you would like to take on today for the future of your community? It's fairly simple, but we walk through this process of three steps to go from brainstorming to action, to setting priorities, but then, importantly, to connecting to the resources that the community might need to be successful. So we'll walk through all those details, but I think the most important thing that I want to say as we get started is that this is all about you tonight. This is all about the community. We don't come with any agenda. We are here to support you in this process of deciding what you want to take on today. I really quickly, before we get going, want to introduce you to a couple of folks, or they're probably folks that you might know. But when we get started with this process, we bring together a steering committee of folks that represent the community to help us build the structure of the process and build the outreach plan and reach out across the community. But we also ask around and we try and identify somebody who would be a real point person to us in the community that can help us to make decisions as we go through the process. Because you all and leaders in this community know Shelburne better than we do. And so we really need somebody who can be that point person for us. And in this case, many people pointed to Jim Brandon as that person. And luckily, he, and it sounds like many times before, he has said yes to being a part of this. So welcome, Jim, and do you want to say a few words?
Sure, thank you, Jen. I appreciate the opportunity to serve as the chair for Shelburne Forward Together. I really want to thank you all for coming out tonight. Beautiful day, Chamber of Commerce sort of day. And so it means a lot that you're willing to take your time to come in here and share your ideas and help us set priorities. I also want to thank Jenna and the VCRD team for doing an outstanding job at the last workshop and for compiling all of that information. There are no less than 25 topics. We're going to try to winnow down to three tonight. So we have a lot of work in front of us. That's all I really want to say right now. I would like to introduce Mike and Shu to come and say a few words.
So much, Kate. A couple more things that I just want to mention before we get started. Give you a round of applause for Good Times Cafe for providing the pizza. I also just want to mention really quickly, Heartwork Shelburne. Kaylee and Ashley are here donating their time to provide childcare. So thanks to them. Topics. They're all compiled here now, so those kind of headlines go away, and now we're talking about action ideas. got back to you. I'm glad that Jim did that counting because I didn't realize there were 25 ideas to review tonight. And here's how we're going to do it. So the meeting tonight is like, it's kind of forum. It's a little bit like game show. And it's kind of fun. But in the end, we are going to end up down at three priorities for action. So we're here and welcome to introductions, overview of logistics. We are, and I'll explain more about this in a moment, we're going to take a quick step back and have a quick visioning conversation. Before we get to action, we're just going to kind of say, so where do we want to go? What's our vision for where this is headed? So we'll do that quickly. We're then going to review the action ideas. So you've got the white sheet in your packet. Those are the ideas that we heard over the last month. We may be missing something, we'll have a chance to add. We may have gotten something wrong, you'll have a chance to let us know. But we are going to read through those together. It's going to feel a little silly. It's really nice to hear them out loud and have a chance to kind of come into the room together and hear the ideas that your friends and neighbors shared in the last month. We'll do that, and then we're actually going to do a really quick voting round. So once we read through them, we have some chance to do some corrections. We're actually going to quickly vote to 8. So we go from 25 down to 8. The question there is, what are the ones you really want to kind of dig into and spend time deliberating tonight? It would be difficult to deliberate on 25 ideas. So we really try and winnow it down and say, what are the kind of most actionable, impactful ideas? We get down to 8, and that's when we do this thing that we call championing priorities. The reason we call it championing is because it's all about standing up and saying, this one is the one that I think is really important. Here's the one that I would want people to vote for. It's speaking for rather than debating against the different ideas. So we'll have a chance to really deliberate and hear from people, hear from your fellow community members, what they feel is most important to vote on tonight. We'll do that for almost an hour, so we have some time there. And then we're going to vote down to the top three priorities. What's going to happen from there is those are the priorities that you've decided, here are the things we want to take action on today. And we're actually going to ask people at the end of the meeting, we'll put some tables out with sign-up sheets, and we'll say, we'd love for you to sign up. You don't have to, but we'd love if some of you signed up to start to get to work on some of these priorities. We'll put that out broadly over email as well, so people get a chance to sign in. And then we're going to close tonight. Next month, on September 28th, at the Shelburne Community School, is our final meeting in this process. And that's the night where we're going to be able to, the three that we select tonight, we'll break out into groups and we'll do some action planning. So it's important to understand in this process, we're going from kind of brainstorming ideas to selecting priorities, but know that there is another step next month where we get to dig into the details of these and say, okay, what are the steps that we need to take? And what are the resources that might be out there to help us achieve these goals that we've chosen? So we will bring a team of resource leaders with us that will help to sit with those groups, not to tell you what to do, but to share some resources that they know are out there, technical assistance or funding or other ways to support the work. So that's where we're headed next month. So again, September 28th, same time, 6:30 at the Shelburne Community School. That's the plan for tonight. Make sense? Questions from the floor about where we're headed? All right. So here's where we're going to start. At that planning meeting, I told you that a couple months ago, we had a group of residents from all parts of the community, town leaders, school leaders, folks from the DEI committee for the town, business leaders. We got people in the room, and we asked them a few questions. They set the topics for conversation last month. They set the outreach plan. The other thing we asked them was, is there usefulness in Shelburne today for a quick visioning conversation? And they all agreed that there was. So that's what we're going to do right now. Alyssa is going to lead us in this conversation. So when you think about what we're going to do in a little bit, is we're going to get into all the detailed action ideas. This moment is to kind of step back from that and say, before we get to work on this, where do we want to go? Once we've accomplished this work that we accomplished, what do we want to see for the future of our town? And so I'm going to have Alyssa kind of run through a little more detail of what this process looks like. It's not science, but we've seen that it's a process that can kind of help to frame the conversation as you get started with setting priorities. Alyssa, do you want me to run through this one? All right. I'm going to run around the room. So I will ask, when you stand up to speak,
so happy to be here. I have to say, in my community development experience, shuttling 128 chairs from the school and then arriving to 30 pizzas hasn't happened yet, so I'm really excited to be here with all of you.
Thank you to the school for the chairs.
Woo-hoo! So last month when we were, for those of you who joined, we were in facilitated forums, and we were really asking for specific action ideas. So I was in transportation and accessibility, and let me tell you, I could name so many different intersections where we think we need a light or a crosswalk or a sidewalk. But this is really that higher level conversation. So this is saying, big picture, again, Shelburne, we have these ideas on the wall. What's your vision for the future of the community? That could be something that's already true today. So that could be something you love about Shelburne right now. And in your vision for the future of Shelburne, that's still true. It could also be something that isn't true yet. It could be something that's aspirational, that you're working towards. When you say, looking back to that conversation in the field house, we said we really wanted to be this thing, and we actually made it. This is not going to be the final round of this vision and conversation. So similar to like we did with the other ideas, Margaret has now got my laptop open. She's going to be capturing notes. So today is getting all of those vision points out there, saying what are those visions for the future of Shelburne. At the next meeting in September, once again, we're going to let folks vote on there. So we will have a list of all of the ideas that were shared. And again, you get a sense from the community of which of those really ring true, which feel like the vision that really represents the full community. We'll share that online as well. So again, this is a first conversation about big picture vision. It's not those specific ideas, it's really saying what are those big picture future things for Shelburne, either that you love now, or maybe that aren't here right now, but you would love to see in the future. Any questions? Right? Any brave individuals? Jenna is gonna get an aerobic workout and run around the room. Just get her steps in, folks. All right, one in the back. Go, go, go.
Now, one thing you're gonna notice about me is I'm not gonna let go of this microphone. And so some of you might try and grab for it, but I'm not gonna let it go.
Here we go.
Thanks, Kim. Who's next?
I agree with all of that, and I would like our town to be diverse, welcoming to all kinds of people, all incomes.
Thank you.
You're good. Janet and I both facilitate too much. We're going to double thank you, and that's not a bad thing. Thank you. I see one over in the back, way over here, Dennis.
It's a good thing we got part here.
So that was Betsy, and that one was a little tough. She said, Bob said there's working farms in Shelburne, so a future where there's still working farms in Shelburne. And great transition to what does that mean for the future? Really that future vision of that similar kind of size and scope. Oh, yes. Here she comes.
I look forward to the day when Shelburne can bring back a real town meeting. And I think that town meeting and the concept of local government we activate at town meeting is really wonderful.
Thank you. Yes.
Hi, I'm Don Stevens, I'm over on Bacon. I want to see a Shelburne that stays affordable. It seems like every project would cost millions of dollars and jack up their prices. And, you know, a lot of people are forced to leave because they can't afford it. So I hope we at least move over there a minute.
I think I saw one hand in the back. Thank you very much.
Sort of building off a couple of things that have been said, really, and my vision is that we will really be able to plan the new housing that we know we need to have. We need to have more affordable housing, but we also need to be mindful of the open spaces, the agriculture, and all of that. So have that plan and not have the town just creep out without some kind of plan. So that's kind of
nice. Does that look a certain way? Sorry, that I asked a follow-up.
I don't know what it might look like, but just that it's really planned and thoughtful. So there are green spaces and there are housing spaces, and they can be spread all over the town. But we don't just become that little center that then just keeps oozing out.
Thank you. Other points, yes. Where she comes. We're using the field house.
Sue Irish, and I guess I care most about the affordable housing situation, but I'd like to support that with child care options so that young families can be here.
So a future Shelburne where young families can be here? Other points of vision, when you look back and say, well, we all sat in the field house, A plus on the chairs. Thank you. Here comes Jennifer. Vision. This has been awesome. Yes, and she's on her way. I see. She floats in blue shirts.
I did just think of, is the sign-up sheet circulating around?
It isn't, but we can start it.
We're just going to start a sign-up sheet circulating around, especially for folks that weren't involved in the first step. These emails are how we update you on the next steps and like, keep everyone up to date on what's going on. So maybe I should start down here. Sorry. So just make sure your name and email are on there. Okay, now I'm ahead. Where were those hands?
My name is Steve Goldstein. I'd like to see a place, whether it's a community center or some place that functions as a so-called third place that's not school or work or home, where people can gather informally and really get to know one another in the community, other than your immediate neighbors.
Thank you.
The addiction and mental health issues and housing.
we love the big picture vision. This is the time. If you have a big picture vision idea, now is the time to share it. We'd love to get just a couple more before we transition to the next portion. Thank you. I think one right here. Oh, did I have a request to repeat?
Okay.
I'm going to do my best to paraphrase. There was a lot there, but I heard the word awe, that you feel a sense of awe when you come into the community, that folks know your name at the post office, and that there's aesthetically attractive housing for all once we define what affordable is. We've got one here, and there was another in the middle as well. Thank you. Calvin is looking for more activities for teens in sheltering, a future vision. Add in the back and then way a little closer to me, and then we'll maybe take two more. Thank you all, folks. This is excellent. And I see, as you can see, Margaret is diligently typing. So again, this is going to come back to you all for a vote. She's made it.
Amazing, Jack. I want to build on one thing that a resident here said, which is we moved here 20 years ago to thereabouts because Shelburne was a smaller village near Burlington like that. And I'd like to see it retain that character. And one of the challenges is Shelburne's, as the previous person said, is pretty great already. And we've seen that a lot of people want to be here. Unfortunately, that raises housing prices. And we somehow have to reconcile. We all want to improve our community. But the question is if part of what makes our community great is that it's small, how do we keep it small? Like if we create all these improvements, and lots more people want to move here, either we build and it's not small, or the housing prices go up. And I don't quite see how you solve that now.
But the vision is keeping it small. All right, I've got gray and then a white on the side, and then we'll come back and wrap up, because we've got lots to do this evening and more to dig into. Right behind you, Jenna, in the white.
like to put out on the table is I would like to see the youth, teenagers, be more involved in this process. I guess in my imagination, I would like to see something in the schools where they can have their own mock city council and bring up the issues that are important to them. The teenagers and the young folks of this community are the ones that are going forward with this plan. They're the ones that are going to be enjoying whatever comes out of this. So I really would like to see the youth be more involved in that. Thank you.
Thank you so much. There was one more here. Someone here decided no. All right, hands now, or we continue on with the process. So what's your vision for Route 7? Ideally, in 20 years, no more traffic? It's 7:10, so back to Jenna.
All right, thank you so much, everyone. I know it can be challenging to want to dive into the ideas and to take that step back, but our hope is that next month, when you're able to review those and make some choices about ones that you want to include in a vision list, it can help to frame the work going forward. To just kind of say, there is some common ground here around what we would like to see. So we'll bring this list back to you on September 28th. also make an online survey so that people can vote on those that aren't able to attend the meeting. And you can share that broadly. We'll take that input in. And that list will just live at the front of the final report that captures all of this process. So the first page of the report will outline those that folks selected to include in that vision list. I hope that can help you frame your work. So now we get into it. The ideas. Here's what we're going to do. And like I said before, sometimes it can feel a little bit like long and silly, but we're going to read them out. And the reason we do this is because many of you might have come into the room with some idea, like, here's what I want to move forward. And it's just this kind of moment to take a step and look at this full list, and not just to read the headlines, but to hear what's outlined in those paragraphs. Because here's how we got to this list. And I know you can't read all of these. That's okay. We're going to narrow them down. But all the ideas up here on the wall, they're all great ideas. And they're all ideas that came from you, your friends, your neighbors. We heard them in the forums, we heard them in the youth forum, we heard them in the survey. And what we did was we read through all of them, and you can imagine that in the forum on, for example, local economy, and in the forum on transportation, there are these kind of pieces of ideas that add up into these bigger picture frames. And so that's the work that we've done, is taking those ideas and kind of added them up so that we don't have 300 ideas to review. We have 25, and hopefully we've captured the essence of people's ideas in there. And so I want to make sure you hear those paragraphs, because that really explains what that headline means and what it's capturing. And that's important as we deliberate about the ideas. So I'm going to ask for folks to go around and read them out loud. Alyssa, so you run with the mic for this one. I'm going to keep it for the next part. And ideally, we go as quickly as possible. So as many volunteers as we have, the better, and as quickly as we can move around, and folks can read twice. Don't feel shy to raise your hand twice. So who'd be willing to, and Anita, who'd be willing to read the first one?
The first one is improve local transportation. A group could work to expand local transportation options and solutions. Many residents shared a desire for expanded bus routes and stops beyond the Route 7 corridor into neighborhoods and to key services in town and beyond. Other ideas include a local shuttle service, van sharing, or a local taxi service. The group could also explore train service between Shelburne and Burlington.
All right, and next one, please.
Coordinate and improve community communications. Create a more coordinated system for community and town communications to build transparency and engagement in community decisions, advertise events, and share resources. A group could create a newsletter and or an improved town website that would share clear and easy to read updates on current events, town decisions or processes, and ways to engage. The group could also help to collect resident input to share back with town leaders to ensure ongoing communication, collaboration, and inclusion.
Thank you. And I should have said this first, but just to note that after we read this list, just so you know, when we vote down to the 8, you're going to have 6 dots that are worth 1 point and 3 dots that are worth 3 points. So just as you're reading through, maybe make some notes to yourself, the ones that you feel like these are the really important ones that I want to focus on, and the ones that you want to buy. Just something to know as you're reviewing the list. Who'd like to read the next one? Next one.
design and build a community center that can serve as a central location to hold events and offer activities and connection for people of all ages. The space could provide youth-led space as well as a programming for seniors, connections for families and children, meeting rooms, a place to share resources, and a central location for programming and workshops.
Unless there's a hand up back there, if you don't mind, then I see.
Improve child care options. A group could work to create locally driven solutions to child care needs, from early education to after school and summer programming for older kids. The group could explore creative solutions to child care challenges, such as developing a fund to help pay for after school activities and daycare, and developing a public-private partnership to attract new early education and after school care.
Next one. Okay, next to you.
Expand and improve community recreation facilities. Shelburne residents of all ages express the need for improved and expanded recreation facilities. The group could identify community needs to plan a build a plan and funding to improve existing facilities and or develop new recreational options. Some ideas include improved soccer fields with lighting, an ice skating rink, a community pool, a water slide, an indoor trampoline park, a playground, a climbing gym, a skate park, and more.
Okay, next on the list. The more volunteers you have, the quicker we get through. Page two. She's coming around. The top of the page.
Create a plan for land use, use and housing development. Work with the town on developing a concrete action plan for future balance of land use, conservation, and housing development, with particular attention to open agricultural land and wildlife habitat. A group could develop a process to gather deep community input and engagement to develop a shared vision and plan for future land use in the community. The group could then use that plan to make recommendations for strategies, policies, and regulations that would help to implement and integrate that plan.
Okay, next one. Thank you very much.
Improve lake access and recreation. Improve access to the lake and support and promote water sports and recreation. The group can help to advance walking or biking paths from the village to the beach or silver shell from the village. Additionally, the group can hold events that showcase the lake and encourage the community to enjoy and celebrate this asset.
Thank you. Next one. Thank you, Elizabeth.
Build a pool. I like this one. Residents of all ages express interest in a community pool in Shelburne that would be free and open for all residents to use. The pool would provide an important recreation resource, gathering place, and an alternative on the days when the beach is closed.
And to be clear, you don't have to agree with it to read it. Next one. Thank you very much.
Advanced waste management solutions. Group could form to take the lead on cleaning up litter around town and supporting effective beach personnel. The group could help to clean up and beautify the village, the beach, and other areas of town, as well as explore alternatives to the food waste management, such as composting, yard waste disposal, and dealing with RV waste.
Thank you. Next one on the list.
Create community infrastructure improvement. Work with the town to develop and upgrade the village's infrastructure, such as wastewater, roads, community facilities, and more. Group can engage the whole community and work with experts and resource seekers to identify key priorities for infrastructure improvements, and then build a timeline to identify all resources to make that plan.
Can you have a hand over here?
I got one.
Sorry, you. Okay. Go ahead.
Expand civic and community engagement. A group could come together to improve the ability of all community members to engage in town and community discussions and decisions. The group could implement initiatives to improve and streamline communications between the community and the town, and to explore ways to make town information and meetings more accessible to all residents. Strategies may include training, and professional development for town leaders on accessibility and inclusivity, improving audio and visual accessibility in community and town meetings, and actively engaging people with disabilities in community decision-making processes. The group could also help the town and other community groups to provide support services and accommodations to make meetings easier and engaging for all members of the community, and maybe write more briefly for these.
We just wanted to demonstrate changes. These types of meetings.
I can't tell. I think the battery maybe is going because it's just going in and out randomly.
Ooh. All right, we'll try it over there. Go, go. Far away.
Opportunities, create informational resources, and propose incentives or other policies to reduce development barriers. The group could also focus on improving options for workforce housing and agricultural housing in programs.
Thank you very much. The next one.
Okay. Revitalize vacant buildings. This group could inventory vacant buildings in the village and along Route 7 and develop a plan to revitalize and repurpose these spaces. Uses for these spaces could include business development, housing development, and other communities such as space for family-friendly activities and businesses, pop-up events, and more.
All right. Next one. Almost there. Folks are behind you, Alyssa.
Thank you.
this page. I'd like to read that one. All right, let me come back.
Advance local business and economic development. A group could form to create and implement a comprehensive economic development strategy for Shelburne. The group could collect public and business input, consult with experts, and review past plans and studies to assess the needs and opportunities for business development in the community. The group could focus on supporting and expanding small and medium businesses, as well as develop a strategy for the future of the industrial park. Additionally, the plan could consider the use of vacant buildings as well as strategies to incentivize and attract the businesses that will meet current community needs and desires.
Okay, thank you. Final page. Home stretch. Who would like to do the next one?
Increased municipal capacity. Many residents expressed appreciation for the services offered by existing municipal staff and expressed a desire for increased services and capacity in areas such as communications and public works. A group could form to work in partnership with the town to explore proposals for increased municipal capacity and help advance those proposals.
And the final idea, right there,
that's the next one. Enhance Shelburne Village Center. The group could form to work with the town and regional and state partners to enhance and showcase Shelburne's Village Center. Many residents identify the village as an asset and shared ideas for ways to improve access to the Village Center and improve safety and traffic in the area. The group could focus on improved signage for the village, holding events that celebrate the village green and parade ground, and showcase and celebrate village businesses. The group could spearhead a plan for the future of the village green and parade ground that engages community and could explore state downtown designation to help with access to technical assistance and resources for the future.
All right, thanks everyone for walking through that exercise. I know it can feel a little bit long, but
ideas that we missed on this list that you'd like to see on the wall when we get into deliberations? Does anyone have one that you see as missing? Or is there anything that we really got wrong that you'd like to correct before we move forward? Yeah.
I'm Ted, and thanks for this process. So this is a question and not what we missed, but considering you've done this before, how do you square the higher level items that I see here, such as infrastructure plan, land use plan, conserve open space and wild, with the nuts and bolts of the issues which fall under them? So I just have a question about how that plays out in the long.
Such a great question. So for folks that couldn't hear, the question was, how do you kind of navigate the fact that some of these are really big kind of umbrella ideas that include a lot of little ideas? And I think the example was like an infrastructure plan for the future of sheltering. With some of the smaller kind of one-piece ideas, not that building a community pool is easy, but maybe that's an example of a kind of concrete, more, you know, pointed idea. They're written that way on purpose, and that's because they were in the notes so clearly in both of those ways. And so some people did share really clear ideas about what we really need as a plan. We need to look at all of our land use and housing. We need to figure out what do we prioritize, where do we prioritize it, where do we put it, where do we not. That was a big idea coming out of the forums. But also, so were some ideas like we need to have ADUs and tiny homes on our property and children. And that came up again and again and again. So in putting these ideas on the wall, I tried to actually on purpose find that balance and let all of you deliberate around what you want to do. You may decide what we really need in this process is to narrow in on those specific actionable ideas that we want to take action on, or you might decide